夠爭取到美國民主共和兩黨行政及立法機關有一個嘅跨黨派共識，係去支持香港係邁向民主，係捍衛人權，同時係建立相應嘅制裁機制，係喺國際社會咧牽制北京。由三年前到今日，其實喺呢段過程裏面咧，都係幾經波折。曾經在兩年前，當我2017年的5月首次前往華盛頓參與國會聽證，當時候香港人權民主法案的聯署人數是基本上十隻手指數得曬，反應可以說是非常慘淡。但是我想由這個人權民主法案過五關，由兩院的外委會到兩院通過，去到今天的總統簽署，其實這個是一個港美關係的里程碑，亦都是象徵著美國對港政策一個重大的調整，是象徵著在現在中美貿易戰之下，美國仍然是會相當重視香港的民主進程以及是人權狀況。這條法案的通過固然一眾在美國的香港人是有他們的付出，在華盛頓的游說和努力，亦都令到這條法案是見到的成績。但我最希望感謝的是由6月9日至今是付出了，亦都是犧牲了，是有很多不同的代價的香港人，是他們的付出先令到美國政界在過去半年對香港的關注急劇上升，最終令到在中美貿易戰之下人權狀況都不會是被貿易議題所掩蓋到，令到在香港主權移交以來第一條是美國的法案與香港有關是正式生效。在未來的日子，香港眾志是會積極是去收集香港各界意見，是去建議制裁名單，無論是濫權的官員以至選舉主任到是黑警，我們相信這些都是有機會是被納入這個制裁名單。有一點必須強調呢，就是其實在這個的香港人權民主法案呢，美國總統特朗普簽署的是一個參議院的法案版本，當中其實有不少的條文是值得改進，包括有五年的日落條款、優先打擊賣港官員黑警未涵蓋到他們的家人。而在香港眾志，我們本身都有駐華盛頓的常委敖卓軒和 HKDC 一個香港人第一次在華盛頓成立的美國遊說組織，都會繼續和香港人在華盛頓在美國當地是去爭取法案加辣。而同時對於未來的制裁名單，我的回應是，其實如果香港的官員或者黑警他們是真心愛國愛港的話，他們就自然不會有物業在美國，亦都唔會驚入唔到美國，因為佢哋應該係支持祖國嘅繁榮穩定，支持大灣區嘅發展。要買物業、要投資嘅話，當然就係去呢一個嘅中國大灣區，而唔係去呢個美國嘅 Bay Area 啦。咁樣，咁但係無論如何，我相信呢一個嘅法案通過係象徵住2014年11月香港係首次有人係推動呢條法案到今日。其實喺2019年之前咧，香港的政黨普遍都是對於香港人權民主法案是避而不談，亦都可能會擔心會不會引來去勾結外國勢力的疑慮。但香港作為一個的國際城市，我們相信我們要爭取國際社會支持，所以我們相信香港人權民主法案這一種的制裁機制在美國落實並不足夠。未來日子，香港眾志和我是會爭取繼續在世界各地是去設立這種的制裁機制，希望讓到官員、黑警世世代代共享大灣區的榮耀。而今晚呢，我亦都係呼籲香港人去到中環係出席呢一個感恩節嘅晚會，而我亦都會喺今日嘅晚上8:30嘅香港時間，用視像方式係出席意大利嘅國會聽證。喺美國通過咗人權民主法案之後，我相信喺未來5年，我哋香港眾志都係會繼續爭取一個嘅骨牌效應，希望喺世界各國，包括係英國、加拿大、澳洲、德國、法國、意大利等地咧，希望係爭取佢哋設立相應嘅制裁機制，係讓世界見到香港同香港人繼續同行。I will say a few words in English. For U.S. President signed on the Hong Kong Human Rights and Democracy Act, that's the remarkable achievement of all the Hong Kongers. with the courage and determination of Hong Kongers to fight for freedom and democracy to start the protest movement on June. It just encouraged world leaders around the world and politicians aware that it's time for them to stand with Hong Kong. Since 5 years ago, we have Hong Kong people try to lobby and advocate the Congress to pass on Hong Kong Human Rights and Democracy Act. In the most downhearted moment, only few, maybe 5 or 6 senators or congressmen endorse or co-sponsor the bill. But now, with how the new bipartisan consensus emerged already, we just already imply no matter Democrats or Republicans, the new bipartisan consensus from both the US administration and the Congress is to stand with Hong Kong to prioritize human rights and democracy and not being overridden by the trade negotiation. With the sharp power expansion and the uprising threat of the authoritarian regime, I just hope in the future we can develop the sanction mechanism around the world, not only in United States, but also in United Kingdom, France, Italy, Germany, and etc. Tonight, 8:30 of Hong Kong time, I will participate the Congress the Parliament hearing in Italy by Skype conference to let the world to know that it's time for them to develop the sanction mechanism. And I think how the US president signed on the bill also developed a clear message for Hong Kong and Beijing government. The escalation of the civil unrest is not depends on protesters. It depends on the government. Now students is still trapped in the polytechnic university. We still suffer in humanitarian crisis. It's still far away for us to investigate with the Independence Committee on Police Brutality. In the future, Demo Sisto will continue to stand with Hong Kong and keep lobbying the world and let the world to stand with Hong Kong. And it's time to sanction government officials with the abuse of power. The returning officers do not respect on procedural justice. And the riot police with excessive force, with the humanitarian crisis and the brutal crackdown on police, and the victory and the achievement of the district council election. No matter people in Hong Kong vote on Sunday, or US president sign on the bill, no matter on local or international level, both we send a clear signal to President Xi. Now is their time for them to reconsider their hardline policy, de-escalate the situation, to investigate on police brutality. 係，咁可以問，係啦，有咩問題可以直接問。過去半年裏面咧，美國總統特朗普咧都對香港嘅抗爭狀況咧，其實都有好多即係五花八門嘅言論啦。咁但係我從來都係強調咧，即係 action speak louder than words 嘅。咁而其實即係一方面特朗普就話佢係會同香港人同埋習近平同行，咁但係另一方面佢亦都咧係會簽署呢條法案。咁我相信香港人咧都係。都係著重佢嘅行動咧，係多於佢嘅言論嘅。咁而其實呢個問題都係問得好好嘅，即係其實未來會唔會有可能係美國嘅，因為法案通過與否就係取決於美國國會，但法案執行與否就係取決於美國嘅行政當局。咁未來會唔會係有呢一個嘅可能性，係隨住中美貿易戰以及係美國對華政策有一定嘅疑慮或者保留，而導致到佢唔啟動相關嘅制裁機制，以至到獨立關稅區嘅一年一檢，最後變成冇牙老虎呢？呢啲嘅疑慮我哋唔能夠排除啦。咁所以其實香港眾志我哋本身喺美國東岸都有羅冠聰啦，同埋直接係有另一位直接係駐華盛頓嘅常委敖卓軒。咁佢哋兩位咧將會係聯同當地嘅香港人係繼續去爭取咧，係去遊說呢一個嘅美國嘅行政當局咧，係要盡快咧喺未來咧係啟動呢一個制裁機制。好記得咧喺九月。是由華盛頓回到香港的時候，我當時已經是跟香港人講，就是說我是有信心這條法案是會在今年裏面完全通過落實並且生效，最終不用等到12月聖誕節了，連感恩節都未到，這條法案已經是順利通過，所以我都是有信心這條法案在未來的日子 我哋都會咧係繼續係聯同當地嘅香港人係繼續咧係去加強個遊說工作。咁重點咧就係希望咧可以盡快啟動個制裁機制，同埋我都相信其實無論係李嘉誠嘅言論，以至到香港總商會，以至到商界近日對於北京以及香港政府處理呢一個抗爭嘅言論咧，亦都係反映咗其實美國當局佢哋係對於香港嘅經濟自由同埋商界係受到呢一個嘅即係紅色資本係所取替咧，係有一定嘅關注。而其實個制裁機制即係有人都會問啦，會唔會係衝擊到香港嘅經濟？咁但係我相信，如果假若係去即係美國嘅行政當局係拒絕呢一個嘅盧偉聰或者係蔡亮女士入境凍結佢哋喺美國嘅資產，咁其實你話呢一個對於香港嘅即係整體經濟會有幾大嘅影響呢？因為其實香港人權民主法案本身就係針對住即係個人嘅制裁，而唔係香港整體經濟上面嘅制裁啦。咁但係無論如何，咁我都係即係奉勸官員們咧，就係睇下佢哋即係嘅資產咧，而家有冇喺美國定係？在美國大灣區定係喺日本嘅灣區定係喺邊度？咁如果即係要確保自己嘅即係未來嘅財政穩健咧，建議佢哋都係全力支持呢個大灣區嘅投資發展咁樣咯。
What exactly are you hoping that the signing of this law will do for Hong Kong people? And you talk about sanctions. Who do you want sanctions to be put on? And why do you think that will
People might ask, is inviting foreign country interference in Hong Kong? And my comment is Hong Kong being recognized as the global city is a must for us to seek for international allies and international community to recognize the unique status of Hong Kong as the global financial center and a world city. With such individual sanction mechanism to target anyone, suppress the Hong Kong people. I believe no matter the head or the chief of the police force, which means Stephen Low, or the one who disqualified me, Mrs. Aaron, are also the one show no respect on basic law, on universal value, and also the fundamental human right. No matter riot police abuse of power,civil servant or government official violate on procedural justice, crack down on the protest, they might be also considered to be sanctioned by the Western world, especially now is the time for them to deliver the message to Hong Kong people. And with certain sanction mechanism being developed, I strongly recognize how the U.S., no matter the administration and the Congress, they sent a clear signal to President Xi, Hong Kong,even is under the hardline rule of Beijing, but we are also the global city that will have foreign businessmen or also expats live here. And how to safeguard Hong Kong's political and economic freedom, that's also would be the criteria and also one of the issues that President Xi or Carrie Lam should not ignore on. In the previous few weeks, we strongly experienced how the foreign minister,or the Chinese Nation Office, or Hong Kong government oppose the Hong Kong Human Rights and Democracy Act, but with the U.S. Congress bipartisan consensus, and how the U.S. President, of course, have the right to decide sign or not sign on the bill or not, now is the time for them experience and realize that they can't ignore the voice. And it's the first time after Hong Kong's handover, U.S. Congress and the President sign on an act related to Hong Kong. 好，仲有冇其他問題？如果冇嘅話，我最後補充多一點啦，就係喺美國唯一同香港有關嘅法案得兩條咧，一個係人權民主法案，另一個係美國香港政策法啦。咁美國香港政策法就喺1992年嘅時候通過，咁當時通過主要原因就係希望去確保香港嘅主權移交之後都能夠獲得一個嘅獨立關稅區嘅經濟待遇啦。咁1992年咧喺呢一個天安門屠城3年之後，美國都選擇係去認可香港喺移交。中國之後係享有一個獨立關稅區嘅權利咧，其實之後咧都係出現一個即係 良性，即係喺北京眼中良性嘅骨牌效應，就喺美國之後，其實相應唔同嘅歐洲國家啦、西方國家啦，都係認可香港作為一個獨立關稅區。咁所以我都相信咧，其實根據90年代嘅往績咧，其實係極有可能咧，係喺美國去通過人權民主法案之後咧，其實見到英國嘅外交部啦，以至到咧其實即係一啲嘅歐洲國家咧，都係討論緊會唔會有即係相類近嘅制裁機制，咁呢一個嘅骨牌效應，政府能否阻止？我相信就係取決於佢哋會否緩和局勢，以及係其實香港人喺香港本地透過我哋嘅選票係向呢一個政權打壓說不，而國際社會美國已經通過法案，我相信解封理大，而且同時獨立調查、改革警隊係刻不容緩嘅。在英國呢其實都會有一個香港半年報告呢，就每年每半年呢是要評價香港的一國兩制是否行之有效啦。咁當然在過去的即係20多年裏面呢，咁呢個英國外交部呢當時都係選擇呢在他們發表香港半年報告的時候呢，是評價這個一國兩制是行之有效，只不過是高度自治受到侵蝕了。我相信在美國，如果英國有這個半年的檢視機制，而美國是直接會由這個美國國務卿有這個一年一檢的獨立關稅區，我相信其實有這個機制本質上就絕對不是一個問題。因為就算香港人權民主法案不通過，其實如果美國總統是有一個的決定的話，其實他明天就可以取消香港獨立關稅區。即簡單來說，其實香港有沒有獨立關稅區對美國來說就當然不是取決於北京的決定，也不是取決於香港，而是取決於美國的對港政策。這個一年一檢的獨立關稅區未來對於香港的政府他們的政經政策會有什麼層面的影響，我想這個就要交給特區政府，除了口頭上面為表忠誠不斷反對法案通過之外，到底他們怎樣能夠向國際社會交代，我相信這個就是林鄭月娥的責任，也都是習近平要去憂慮的事情。我想有一個很實際的客觀問題，就是即使這個的美國法案即是這個香港人權民主法案通過了之後，即是由即係特朗普都簽咗呢個法案幾個鐘啦，咁你話係咪由呢一開始，所有嘅香港人喺美國嘅資產，包括係即係美國嘅即係香港官員喺美國的資產都不能夠轉移呢？我相信其實個問題就係因為嗰個制裁名單喺呢一刻，即係我相信佢哋都未有定案啦。而其實呢一個嘅美國國會即係都即將感恩節假期啦，咁亦都準備聖誕假啦。咁其實個會期喺2019年剩翻嘅日數都唔多啦。咁所以我諗呢方面我哋都會同喺華盛頓嘅團隊了解翻啦。咁但係無論如何其實我諗對於香港官員來說最大的阻嚇力其實不是美國的制裁，而是英國的制裁。即正如上任特首梁振英和現任特首林鄭月娥，其實他們全家人都不是美國人，但他們是英國人來的。所以我想其實最大的阻嚇力和最大的疑慮，其實是英國如果都建立類似的制裁機制，才會對於很多的公務員來說，以至到是對於這個的香港官員來說是會有壓力。而都奉勸即香港的官員們，就是他們即自己都好好去反省他們過去半年給國際社會一個什麼的訊息，為什麼兩年前只有5-6個國會議員去聯署法案，去到今天會有一個壓倒性的全票通過，那這個他們自己跟習近平交代了。
What's your message to US President Trump and why is it in his interest to help you and listen to you?
It's not necessary to helpme, but it's a must to safeguard Hong Kong political and economic freedom for US president. As we recognize that with the trade war or the trade negotiation, always, especially with the primary election in the Democratic Party, lots of criticism of how US President Trump might face of how he override human rights by trade deal,or how human rights condition in Hong Kong is being hijacked by business interests. And I think with the upcoming US presidential election on next year, it will just put more pressure on US president, because no matter he signed on the bill or not, the act will still pass. And that's why for him to sign on the bill, as last action speak louder than words. In the past 6 months, U.S. president always have different kind and different approach to comment on Hong Kong situation, just like how he has a track record criticized protesters as rioters. But rather than just focus on the verbally statement of the verbal statement of President Trump, I think more important is his action. And now is the time for the Western world to stand with Hong Kong. 好，唔該曬大家。Thank you.